Hi, I'm Julie from the Exploratorium. Welcome to Viral Questions, a series of videos where we answer your questions about COVID and vaccines. Today, we're going to dig into the question, will a vaccine change my DNA? The quick and short answer is absolutely not. So why are people asking that question? I think some of the confusion might be because the vaccines currently in use for COVID are referred to as genetic or nucleic acid vaccines. Remember, the goal of a vaccine is to train your immune system to recognize a foreign invader without you having to get sick first. If you need a refresher, you can check out our earlier videos on how COVID vaccines work. In the past, the most common ways to train your immune system to recognize a virus were to introduce a weakened or inactive form of the virus, or to introduce a fragment of its exterior, such as the spike protein on coronavirus. There are currently COVID vaccines in development and in use around the world that utilize these more traditional strategies. The first three vaccines approved for use in the United States all use nucleic acids, that is RNA or DNA, that teach your cells how to make coronavirus spike proteins rather than introducing the actual spike protein itself. In the case of mRNA vaccines, the messenger RNA is delivered into your cell where it gets translated into spike proteins. Your DNA stays protected in the nucleus of your cell. The mRNA never goes near it, and your DNA is unaffected, even as the cell starts making spike proteins. In the case of the viral vector vaccines, the ones based on adenovirus carry the information in a strand of DNA. That strand of DNA does get into your nucleus. It needs to go there to get transcribed into mRNA, which then goes back into the main part of the cell to do its job. The new piece of DNA does not interact with your body's DNA, and it will not get copied into new cells if the vaccinated cell happens to divide. Now, there are some viruses out there that do interact with your cell's DNA, but none of those are involved in any part of this process or in any current vaccine. It might feel unsettling to think about genetic material being introduced into your cells, but that's what happens every time a cell gets infected with any virus. That virus's RNA or DNA gets into your cells and tells them how to make more viruses. In the case of these new vaccines, the RNA or DNA only introduces the instructions for how to make a spike protein, rather than how to make a whole coronavirus, which is what would happen if you were infected with SARS-CoV-2. It's important to note that while both of these techniques are new for vaccines, they've been in development and testing for other treatments for many decades. They're currently our best strategies for training your immune system to recognize the virus that causes COVID without having to actually get COVID. Thanks for watching, and please keep sending us your viral questions. We'll see you next time.